And so what we're dealing with here is an extraordinary event. Australia is becoming a harder country to live in because of these natural disasters.
The reason why people on the ground feel like they've been abandoned, that's what they've said. They feel like they've been abandoned by government, state government, federal government. Do you understand why they feel that way?
Yes, I do. And it is very common in natural disasters that the frustration and the anger and the sense of abandonment, this happens in almost every natural disaster.
Do you take because of the scale? Why they feel abandoned?
I feel deeply and empathise absolutely with how people feel when they find themselves in these situations. As the rain comes pouring down and places are cut off, and the inability of get help, whether they be Defence Force assets or trucks and vehicles and others, this is a very complex and very challenging environment in which to operate. I don't think in situations like this there can ever be enough support. There can never be enough support in a natural disaster such as this. I mean, no amount of support is going to measure up to what people need in a desperate situation like this. I'm just being honest with you. I mean, every resource can be applied, but I can guarantee you whatever is supplied will still not measure up because of the sheer desperation of the situation people found themselves in. But what I am amazed at, as we've seen this in disaster after disaster around this country, is the combination of both the community response, together with response provided by local, state and federal governments, means right here, right now, we are in the process of rebuilding, and we will rebuild.
Is there a national emergency? Why did it take so long?
Well, I don't think it has taken long, and I don't think it... I mean, we're following the process that is required for such a declaration. And so, you know, as yet, we still haven't received a formal recommendation from either of those states, and that's why I've taken the initiative to request such a direction or a recommendation, and I look forward to that to be completed over the course of the week.
7 or 8 days ago?
Because the nature of the disaster over a week ago is different to what it has emerged over the last week.
Are you concerned that more and more people are going to become very angry because they don't think your government is doing enough to wean Australia off coal and other fossil fuels?
Well, I'd make 2 points. Obviously, climate change is having an impact here in Australia, as it is in every country around the world. And that's why, as a government, we're the first government to commit to net zero by 2050 in Australia. That's what our government did. That's what we've done. Our government has now seen emissions fall by over 20%. Now, they can't say that in New Zealand. They can't say that in Canada. They can't say that in Japan. They can't say that in the United States. You can say it here in Australia, because that's what we've achieved through the climate policies that have seen emissions fall. And we've got $21 billion invested over the next 10 years to ensure that we continue to reduce those emissions. But this is one of the big differences between our climate policies and perhaps some others. I'll tell you what's not going to fix climate change. What's not going to fix it is just doing something in Australia. And then in other developing countries, their emissions continue to rise. That won't change the climate here in the Northern Rivers. What changes the climate in the Northern Rivers is if the global climate is affected. And that's why the technology work that we're doing, which we're doing with Indonesia, which we're doing with Vietnam, which we're doing with India, with countries that have rising emissions profiles, we need to be able to give them the commercial technology that enables their countries to get on a lower emissions, net zero emissions profile over the next generation. Now, if you don't achieve that, you know, you can get a warm, fuzzy feeling here in Australia. And I think it's great that we've reduced emissions by 20%, and I think it's great we've got a commitment to get to net zero by 2050. But the real challenge of addressing climate change is ensuring that we're working together with other countries in our region, and particularly developing countries, to ensure we have the technology that changes how they're able to grow their economies. And that's what Australia is seeking to do, and is a leader in the world in seeking to do. Thanks, everyone.